This is Chicho. We're on September 16, 2019. We're 2 weeks into the beginning of the school year. Okay. It's been a busy start. I usually don't, my busy season usually doesn't start until the end of September. For some reason, this year it just kicked in right at the beginning of September. And what we're gonna do today is we're gonna list one more batch of comic books on eBay. Now, I haven't been doing live streams for all the comic books we've been listing on eBay. I've been probably half of them, or a little bit more than half, I've been doing live streams of. The odds are, because we've been doing this for about 3 months now, 2.5 months, right? So I wanted to go 3 months. So the odds are, by the end of September, whatever we end up listing on eBay, that's the data, and whatever we end up selling on eBay, that's the data we're going to use to start doing some ASMR mathematics regarding personal finance, and start taking a look at some of the ratios and some of the indicators, what it means if you're going to invest in anything, what the rate of return and all that jazz is going to be. And we're definitely going to link up this stuff to what we started a few years ago for series 4 of the language of mathematics, which is units and ratios, right? We're almost there. We're almost there. Okay. Aside from that, this is an unannounced live stream. So I'm not sure how many people are going to get dropping by. I'm just going to pop out the chat. I sort of did an announcement on Gab. I hope it went through on Minds and on Twitter, just announcing it, right? So we'll leave it there. And what I'm going to do is, just in case, because this will be loaded on BitChute and YouTube, Daniel Lockyer. Hello, hello, how are you doing? Twitch and Jason, how's it going? Good afternoon, Chicho. How's the school year treating you so far? Busy school year. Brother, it's been a busy school year. Lavia, how are you doing? An unannounced live stream. I had some time and I wanted to, I made some promises to people who've been checking out the comic books we've been listing on eBay, and they've requested for me to list some of the comic books, and I've made some promises, so I really wanted to do this one to list some of the comic books that I've told people that I'm going to list. And by the way, if anybody's watching this that it was interested in some of the comic books that the video I put out where I showed you guys about four short boxes of comic books we're going to list, the odds are this is going to be the last large batch I'm going to be listing on eBay or this month, right? Because I want to start taking that data and crunching that data. I'm busy with the school year, so it's going to be a little lull period for what we're going to list on eBay. I'll definitely continue, make sure I have on a frequent basis as the mermaid comics up there, because it's basically the only place you can get them. The other books that I have in my collection, they might be random comics being loaded, but we're going to really slow it down. And at the end of this month is the last bit of data we're going to take to do our analysis for the ASMR math stuff that we're doing. Sorry about that long intro. It's just connecting up to a lot of things. But one thing I did really want to do, I made some promises to have some comic books up, and we're going to start listing some of those. Okay, first, and whatever else chance I get, I'm going to list more. So if there's anything you wanted from that video, send me a message. Say, Chicho, please list this before you slow everything down. Okay. Hey, Chicho, glad I caught the stream. Hope you're okay. Doing well, King. Doing very well. Having a good time with the fall. Fall's kicked in here. So everybody's energy's changed a little bit. It's more chill, it's more relaxed, believe it or not. and everybody's sort of bunkering down for winter. So I've started eating heavier food, and getting into the school year in fall mode, right? So it's going good. I like the season. I like every season, really. Just when I was about to open my math book to do some homework, you start. Awesome. By the way, Olivia, if there's any times that work best for you for the math live streams that you need help with, drop us a line on Discord and I'll try to fit it according to the times that people would like me to be live to do some mathematics, okay? And that goes for anyone. If you guys need me to be on at a certain time, you have questions and stuff like this, let me know. But make sure you please you set the times according to my time zone. It's sometimes I do miscalculations trying to figure out which time zone people are talking about. So PDT, PST, West Coast of Canada, United States. That's the time zone I'm in. Okay. Spot of tea, how are you doing? How's life? So let me show you what I got planned to list here. Let me just do a little uptime so I know, because I'll try to put a little bit of, so six and a half minutes in, we're gonna start showing you guys the comic books. There's a, I don't, you know, I've told some people I'm gonna be listing some comics. I'll try to list as many of them as I can that people have wanted to. Good. Moving away to university on Friday. Awesome. We're gonna list another Infinity Gauntlet, number one, and Infinity. We're gonna list an Infinity War, number one. I haven't listed this one. I'm gonna list the Infinity Gauntlet first. If we get a chance, I'll list, and I've already graded this one too, which is super sweet. 9.4. I wonder why I graded this one. Not sure. I graded this one already, but we do have to take pictures of it, right? So we're gonna list this one first. If I get a chance, I'm gonna list this guy as well. We're gonna list. I try to anyway. Omega Man number five. Oh, sorry, number three. First full appearance of a logo. Okay. And yeah, I think I paid $5 for this when I bought it. Right? First appearance of logo. I left. Kept the sticky on there. Okay. And I got the rest of the Omega Man Lobo appearances, okay, except for number 37 here. Okay. So there's Omega Man number 5, Omega Man number 9, Omega Man number 10, Omega Man number 19, and Omega Man number 20. And number 10 is the first full appearance of Lobo. I don't know if you, it wouldn't be the first full appearance of Lobo. First full Lobo story. That's what it says here, Omega Man number 10. And he's on the cover of this one as well, right? These go fairly cheap. I don't know why. I really don't. Hey, Chicho, do you announce you're going live? Sleepy Waves, I announced it on Gab, Minds, and Twitter. I didn't announce it on Discord because I'm assuming Discord automatically sends announcements out. And those are the only places that I know. This is an unannounced live stream. I didn't schedule it in. I've just been crazy busy for because of the school year starting. I didn't realize I was going to get hit with a wave of people wanting to do mathematics right off the bat. So I got sort of overwhelmed with emails coming in. So I had to deal with the students and organize and set their schedule. That's the first wave. There's another wave coming. I see usually I get them through the Patreon. Oh yeah, I didn't announce it on Patreon. The unannounced live streams I'm not announcing through Patreon. Sorry, Sleepy Waves. Maybe I should be doing that. I just haven't done that through Patreon where you send a message to everyone saying, oh, I guess I could do a post on Patreon and it automatically sends it. That's right. I didn't even think about that, brother. I didn't even think about that. I don't want to overwhelm people that are supporting me on Patreon, because if you're supporting me on Patreon, you know what I'm up to. You know the grand design. I hope you do, right? And I'm gonna get more active on Patreon when we start getting closer to bringing it all in, right? But if you, Sleepy Waves, if you want me to announce these things on Patreon, let me know and I'll do it as well. I'll start announcing on Patreon, right? I just don't want to overwhelm people with a whole bunch of notifications, right? Sometimes I find it overwhelming. So I'm moving from my hometown, Swansea, to Abries. Wow, what a name. Abries. What? Town, they're towns in Wales. So sorry if they're spotty. They're unpronounceable. They're unpronounceable. I'm from the UK, so I'm familiar with the names. Cool. Let's do, and I've promised people, there's someone that's been waiting for a lot of aliens coming up. So I think what we're gonna do, we're gonna list Infinity Gauntlet number one up. We're gonna list Omega Man number three up. Okay. I'm gonna list the main ones and then the follow-throughs, right? Because I don't know how deep we're gonna, how long I'm gonna, how many comics I can load on in the amount of time I have, just because I've started to get really busy, right? I've promised, there's someone that's waiting for Valiance. So I'm gonna load up. We already have Eternal Warrior number five up. Okay. I'm gonna list Eternal Warrior number four. First cameo appearance of Bloodshot. Okay, this is an important book. And Rye number zero, first full appearance of Bloodshot. And we already have Eternal Warrior number five up, which is the second full appearance of Bloodshot. So there's four books, and these ones are going to be fast for us to do. I just need to take pictures of them because we've already sold. We've sold, I think, like two or three Infinity Gauntlets already. We've sold an Omega Man, in poor condition. This one, I don't know the conditions of these. I gotta check into them. The Infinity Gauntlet I gave 9.4, so I'm assuming that's what it is. And we've already sold an Eternal Warrior number one and a couple of Rye number zeros. Okay. These ones I'm gonna put back when if I get the chance, I'm gonna list them. Okay. I watched the Cure video finally last night, and I must say I'm so amazed. Pineapple liqueur, it still needs to cure. I've never made pineapple, so I'm tasting it every few weeks just to see how the taste changes over time and it settles in, right? I wish I could find organic fruits around me, but I think I'm gonna give it a go regardless with my sprayed mass farm fruits. Yeah, why not, Sleepy? Seriously. And it's alcohol too, so with liqueur you can't go too selective with the organics. If you got delicious fruits, organic or not, sugar, vodka, or gin, or anything else. Nice. We're in the UK. That's that. Currently, mile last. How long does it take for it to be settled? To settle, it varies on the fruit. Sleepy Waves, the strawberries within a month they were phenomenal. Really, they tasted fantastic. Within 2 weeks, I tasted them, I think, and they were pretty good. Within a month, the strawberries were amazing. This is the pineapple. I forget when we put it together, and it's not bad, but it still has a little bit of the sharpness to it. So I think that's been a month and a half. So it varies, right? The pineapple is probably gonna need about 3 months for it to fully get that flavor in. Been watching Chicho live for a long time. Daddy-o, nice. Thanks for watching for a long time. Oops. Sorry about the noise. Okay, we put these ones back. If we get the chance, we do these as well. Valiant here as well. I'm not gonna actually, we're gonna do this guy as well. This is an important book. First full appearance of Archer and Armstrong. Okay, so we'll do this guy as well. Basically right now I'm gonna pick out the books we've already listed. Okay, that way, most of them anyway, we haven't listed an Archer and Armstrong. That way I can list more, because I know people are waiting for some of these, right? We've already sold one of these, Amazing Spider-Man 346. I used to sell it for $8 when I did shows, right? It goes for higher now. Dante, what's up? Do you recommend to not open the jar for at least a month, or does it not matter if oxygen gets it? It really doesn't matter. For me, usually I leave them alone, but with new types of fruits, I do sample them as the flavor is kicking in. The ones that I've made before, I know how long it takes. Like blackberries in general, wait at least a month and a half to 2 months, right? A month is okay, but usually a month and a half to 2 months. Blueberries, at least a month. Strawberries, now within 2 weeks, I'm gonna start sampling, right? My first Chicho video was his first comic book. Awesome. That was a great haul, man. That was a fantastic haul. Those Daredevil books were amazing. Right? And the other stuff. Amazing Spider-Man number 60. We've already sold one of these. I was selling this for $6 when I was doing conventions. And Amazing Spider-Man 262. Okay. Back in the day, 90s, I was selling this for $5. It goes for more now. All of those, right? Strawberries, is there something better than vodka? I don't know. You could try gin. I've never made it with anything else. I think you need a history section in your Discord. Sure, Dante. If you want, throw it in there. I think you have access to it. That'd be great. Make channel. Yeah, mods can make channels, don't they? I gotta throw up the mermaid books. So Mortal Coil, Ashcan, right? I'm gonna throw one of these up. You know what? History, I think, would be heavy, unless people want to start talking about history of publishing and whatnot. But history in general for me has a very, very political slant to it. I would say heavy, but then we could put one in light as well, right? Eye for an Eye number one. Eye for an Eye number two. Eye for an Eye number three. Okay. Now I'm not sure if we're gonna get to do all these for this live stream. I'm just showing what I'm going to list. Even if we finish the live stream, I haven't got to everything. That way people know what I've picked out first to list. That's an habit. Awesome. Thanks, Spotify. There's one set of books that I printed, I haven't listed yet, and I will do. And these are, let me show you these guys. This is Lander number one. These are the lowest print runs we did. There aren't that many of these around. Okay. Lander number one, Inks by Dick Ayers, right? I've talked about those. Lander number two. Okay. Again, only a few hundred of these were printed. Pretty rare. Okay. Lander trade paperback that has the reprint of number one and number two, plus it has the story for the third issue. So it's three issues in one. Okay. Again, only a few hundred of these were printed. Okay. There's other books that I've promised. Hold on, let me check to see what else I promised. think I promised Spider-Gwen to someone. I have Spider-Gwen here as well. That I will be listing, I believe. Omega Man, Spider-Gwen, I promised. Let me see. Valiant, Eternal Warrior, 4 and 0. And other Valiants, I promise as well. So, at least this one I know as well. These guys. Okay. First appearance of Bishop, right? Here, I'm going to show you. First appearance of Bishop. Second appearance of Bishop. And third appearance of Bishop. Do I still buy rare comics? For sure, for sure. I was trying to get my hands yesterday on a higher grade Honeymooners number 12, the reading that we did, right? Jackie Gleason Honeymooners number 12. I was trying to get my hands on a higher grade copy that I have. I got way overbid. I'm very low budget, right? And someone who'd graded it as an 8, and it wasn't an 8. You looked at it, it was maybe 6, right? No, more than 6, 7, right? So 7, he had graded as an 8. A 7, Jackie Gleason Honeymooners went for $180 US. My bid was a lot lower. I do still collect rare comics. Or sought after comics and stuff. I just haven't been in a buying state for the last year or so because we went ballistic buying a lot of books, right, in the last 5 years, 6 years. So let me put these over here. Which ones are going to list first? Let's list Eternal Warrior and Rye first. So let me move these guys over. There's a few other books that I have that I want to list as well. I think we have, let me tell you how many books I have that I can list for free for the rest of this month. Might as well. Last month we listed more than what was allowed. I got another 38 that I can list this month in September for free. I'm not sure if we're going to hit it or not. We'll see if it happens. Okay. So let's do Eternal Warrior number 4, Rye number 0, and Infinity Gauntlet number 1 first. And then we're going to hit up the Spider-Mans. Okay. And then we'll hit up Archer and Armstrong and Omega Man number 3. Okay. Let's do Rye number 0 first. Switch up, and I do have the angle set up here as well, right? Let me do up time so I know when we actually started listing comics up. I find it pretty easy when I look through the videos. 24 minutes, that's not bad. So Rye number 0, first full appearance of Bloodshot. Oh, I've already graded this. Sweet. Nice. I graded at 9.6 already. Okay. Very nice. I wonder why I graded these. Why did I grade this? Did I grade this one too? No, I haven't graded this one. So I got the Infinity Gauntlet graded. Let me show you. Let me make sure I haven't listed this. I know I haven't listed this. No. And let me make sure. No, I know I haven't. So I must have graded it just because, right? So let's see. So cool. Okay. So let's do this. So all we gotta do is just take pics of it, really. And I'll just confirm it's a 9.6. Why not? Why not? It's too bad I didn't take pictures of it already. Okay, the tapes we don't need. So let's just put the tapes here for now. Oh yeah, let me open up this angle as well. Here, right? Where I'm gonna lay down the comics. And it's got the new bag and board, so that's fine. Oh, yeah, isn't that beautiful copy? And we got our camera. Now I gotta turn it on. We didn't turn it on. Nicholas, how you doing? Hey Chicho. Hey chat. Hope everyone is well. Chicho, when you get a minute, don't you do a video on dealing with grief? Yes, Nicholas. Is it dealing with grief? It's dealing with life. The basically apologies for being straight up. It's basically dealing with the shitstorm that life deals you, right? True. Grief. It's, I want to make sure it's not going to start. Here's the link, Nicholas, if you're looking for it. There's a lot to that. Okay, I was searching for it for my girlfriend. She just lost her aunt and I couldn't find it. I think that's the one you're looking for. I hope that's the one. I grabbed it really quick. I'm pretty sure it is. My pleasure, man. And my best to your girlfriend. It is a lesson of life. This one is at least a 9.6, if not 9.8, but who knows what those guys do with their rankings and stuff. Yeah, very nice copy. Very nice copy indeed. So let's put that there. Let's close this up. first cameo appearance of Bloodshot. Important book. This book is going to, my guess, is only going to go up in value. Just my two cents. Famous last words in investing. It's only going to go up, right? But the first, it's just the one panel. That's it. It's Rye number zero and Eternal Warrior number five really should be worth equivalent to this, but they're worth way less than this. I think because people weren't expecting this to come out, so they ordered, but there was a, I don't know, I think this is more on the common Valiant side than not, right? But it is an important book. Let me actually check the. Copy. Take a look. I should have shown you the other one too, but let's see if we can focus on that. Yeah, you can't see it. Nice copy, nice copy. Let's do a flip. Oh no, we're gonna take pictures of it. I almost forgot to take pictures of it. And it is a beautiful cover. Very beautiful cover. It's the same back as the Rye number zero. Pictures of the corners from the front. BD, how are you doing? Beat this. Hey Chicho, glad to catch a stream. Hope you're doing well. Doing well, brother or sister. Thank you. So this is minimum. Absolute minimum grade of 9.4. It's most likely a 9.6. I'm gonna take picture in the front and the corners, okay? Because the Valiant Comics pre-Unity, and I guess after Unity as well, after Unity, the edges, they were always, it wasn't like rolled over. You could see the seam, right? So let me do a flip on this. It's pretty good. Let's take a picture of this. Is it in focus? Give this guy a 9.4, 9.6. On the low end, 9.4, on the high end, 9.6. So I give it 9.4, 9.6. So let's keep this in. I'm going to take pictures of a few issues, like probably around 5 or so, and then we'll put them up. As long as I'm hooking up the camera, I might as well transfer over a few pics in one shot. Let's use our little stickies. Can I just use this? That's Eternal Warrior number 4. Next one. We already gave this one a 9.4. Infinity Gauntlet number 1, right? So I gotta take pics of this. Let's make sure that's the gray. Pics of it. It's a nice book. And again, this one has the same issues as the Eternal Warrior number 4 with this, but this one's harsher than Eternal Warrior number 4. So they must have got them. The odds are printed at Quebecor Printing in Montreal. Okay, that looks like a great copy. Yeah. We're gonna do. Let's do these in this order. Let's go Amazing Spider-Man 346, 360, and 362. And I don't have these graded. So, let's do. I should list from the Valiants. I might list Magnus Robot Fighter number 1 and number 5 as well. Depending if the person that's looking for the Valiants contacts me and says, Chicho, please put those up as well. See, there's a little, like, you can't even see it, really. The minutest crease. And the color hasn't broken yet. Let me see, where is it? Very sweet. So, can you see it? Can you see it? Come on, focus. 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 That was blurry. That was so blurry. Where is it? Difficult to open up the window. The weird cat meowing. Animal Eyes, how are you doing? Thank you for the Twitch Prime sub. Appreciate it, brother. Look at this. Mm-hmm. nice comic. We're gonna give this a 9.4. 9.2. Let's give it a 9.2, 9.4. You'd be hard fetch up give it a 9.2, but might as well make somebody happy for buying a 9.2 and getting a 9.4. Yo, Chicho, much love, brother. Much love right back, Sneaky Walrus. Anvilize, it's 4 months, eh? That's cool, man. Subscribe for 4 months. Always love your comic content. It's the best. Thanks, man. Really enjoy it as well. It's been really fun, actually. Because trying to get the data that we needed to do the math stuff, I have to force myself to get on eBay and go through the song and dance of learning all the eBay little intricacies. And eBay's, man, they got some, you know, scam factor in there. Like when they automatically relist your listing, they automatically click on take offers now. And then from what I understand, if someone sends you an offer, you don't notice that. Someone sends you an offer, you decline the offer because that's your minimum bid, minimum you're willing to take for a book. eBay charges you for the offer and stuff like that. It's just craziness. Some of the stuff they do is insane, right? 9.4. These Wall Street corporations, right? Messing around with us comic book collectors. Okay, these tapes are. Make sure it doesn't snag. Let's do this. And do this. So, Amazing Spider-Man 360. We're gonna list. Cletus Cassidy. And you see a little bit of Carnage in this one too. Let's see what kind of grade we got there. Let's see what kind of grade we got there. Oh, what a nice book. Oh, what a nice book. What a nice book. The spine is not touched. Look at this guy. Not that I can see anyway. Look at that. Look at that. Nice if I can see. Like a nice spine. Oh, from the top, it's a 9.8. We'll have to see what the back looks like. Right? Oh, let's do it back. Spine is beautiful. This is a nice, nice book. Let's do a flip on it. Let's see what we got. I got a good board. Let's take a look. Spine's like not touched. Wow, this is a really nice copy. It's got the printing cut thing that Marvel does, but that's doesn't affect it. Okay, let's take this of that. That's 12 pegs, that's the max allowed, right? So, get this fresh one of you. Okay, this is a 9 point, as far as I'm concerned, 9.8, right? But I'm gonna say 9.6, 9.8, okay? Chaminade, Chaminade. Hey Chicho, I've just tried my lemon liqueur based on your recipe for the first time and it's so damn good. That's my pleasure, man. The lemon one is amazing. And that one, as it ages, it just becomes so much, so much. And it's good for the tummy. This guy, 9.6, 9.8. Without a doubt, without a doubt. I would say 9.8, 10. But I'd say 9.8. I should just say 9.8. Let's go 9.6, 9.8. We don't want anybody to. I had to, by the way, I had, right now, I have Sandman number 8 up as well. And there was a buyer that bought Sandman number 8, Silver Surfer number 50, and Hulk number 377. And he hadn't paid for, you know, he hadn't settled the account for a few days. And I sent the invoices and stuff. And he sent me an email saying that he couldn't buy it. He didn't get the funds he was expecting to get and stuff like that. So I canceled the order. He asked me to cancel the order. Okay. So, you know, I canceled the order. I didn't leave him a negative feedback or anything because, you know, life happens, right? It's not something that the person's been doing. As far as I know, to me, he's never done so. Life happens. I gave this a 9.6, 9.8. Okay. Amazing Spider-Man 360. So I have those up right now as well. And Sandman number 8, First Appearance of Death. That's an important book. And he got it a good deal. Unfortunately, he couldn't follow through. Right. Amazing Spider-Man 362. Okay. Second full appearance of Carnage. Let's see what this condition is like. Let's check it out. Let's check it out. Nice book. Beautiful book. Look at these things. This spine is like untouched, right? Untouched. Obviously never been read, right? Beautiful. comic is a little off-center. It's a little off-center, the comic. Yeah, you can see that. But the spine untouched. Untouched. There's a little bit of red printing ink there. I don't know if you can see it. Right? It's part of the printing process, so I'm gonna give this one a 9.4, 9.6. Well, no, we're gonna give it a 9.6. This is a 9.6. 9.4 would have a ding or something on it. Six. So let's do this, let's do this, let's do this. Let's give it a straight up 9.6. Take a picture of. Oh yeah, we got Omega Man number 3 here too as well. We got two more to take pictures of. Archer and Armstrong number 0. First full appearance of Archer, the little guy, and Armstrong, the big guy. Okay. And from this universe, this is a Valiant universe, Archer is actually a Psyop. He picks up fighting abilities. He learns like instantly when he watches anything, right? And Armstrong is immortal, in essence, immortal, and he's really strong, and he's part of the Anipada brothers. Let's take a look at this. This was a great series, and the artwork is Barry Windsor Smith. Beautiful copy. Very nice copy. This is cheap as far as I'm concerned. This is one of the most important, one of the important books that Valiant had put out. Nice. We're gonna give this guy like 9.4, 9.6 in from the cover page, right? We'll see what the back looks like. Let's take a look at it first. See if there's anything I need to take a picture of. Wow, the spines of these are phenomenal, right? Okay. Rabbit Teeth, hello, hello, how are you doing? Beautiful book. This is 9.4, 9.6, without a doubt, without a doubt. 9.6, but we'll say 9.4, 9.6. Maybe we should say 9.6, 9.8. But we don't want people to be disappointed. Better people felt good about their buy than bad. Terminator 2. That's what the advertisement is on the back of this. T2. Nine point four, 9.6 on this one, right? Not higher. It's at least a 9.6. Or a 9.8. 9.6 at least. But we're going to go 9.4, 9.6. And we got first appearance of Lobo, Omega Man number 3. And first full appearance of Lobo. And we've done a reading of this, right? We did a flip through all of those, I think. Or we did at least a reading of Omega Man number 3. If you do Chicho Omega Man number 3 or Omega Man or Lobo, you should find it. And there's two Lobo readings that we did. One of them was the first black comic book hero from Dell Comics. And there's a serious story involved with that, right? Because a lot of comic book stores didn't like having a black hero in comic books, so they refused to sell Dell Comics and they sent them all back, and Dell was only able to put out 2 issues of that, right, before they had to cancel it because there was a racist backlash from certain comic book stores, right? Mega Man number 3, let's check this out. Toph has been a little squished. See if you can see it. It's got some wrinkles in there. Okay, come on. There it is. You can see it, right? What would you call this? Creases? Some pressure from the top? And this, I know when this happened. This wasn't there. This happened when I sent my comic books from Ontario to come here, and one of the comic books was damaged, the box was damaged, and that's from that, and it contained a lot of Lobo, a lot of Omega Man number 3. Otherwise this was a beautiful, beautiful copy. There was a lot that didn't get damaged, but there was a part where, because I have more copies of this, right, and Lobo, one of my favorite characters, I was very pissed. But what can you do? What can you do? It is what it is, right? It is what it is. And this will be, this could straighten out through a press, I guess. I don't know, I don't press. Right. So, what does that bring it down to? Without it, it would have been a 9.4, 9.6. With it, that's unfortunate, but overall, Sturmer, it's a beautiful book, man. Like, look at the spine. aside from that, take a look. Oops, let me bring it there. Like there's no what do you call it? Scratches, dings, or anything, right? Let's check out the back. Tron. Look at this. Tron. Yeah, this is a beautiful book. Ah, well, that's what happens. That's what happens, right? Let's take pictures. Unfortunate. Show in the picture. Need an angle on. There we go. Okay, let's see if we can get that. Get a reflection to show it. And spin this around, see what gives me the best angle. This part too, because it does show on the back as well. So that's it, that should show it. There we go. Okay, that's good. So let's put this on the board. So what should we grade this as? What should we grade this as? It's a beautiful book otherwise. I'm gonna give it a 8.5. Okay. Is it an 8? It's not an 8. No way. Is it a 9? No, not a 9. So whenever I decide to grade a book, I always ask myself, is it one grade higher? If it is, then I give it that range. And if it's not, then I look down. Is it one grade lower? And if it's not one grade lower, then you did a pretty good job grading it according to my personal perspective on it, right? And this thing, like, look at this. Like, you can't even see it from the front, right? So this should really be 8.59. Right, but I'm not going to give it a 9. I'm going to give it an 8.5. 8.5. Let's put the number on it. I've seen for the first time, I don't know why I didn't see this before, in the comic book store that I go to, my local comic shop where I have my pull list, I actually saw a sign last week on Wednesday where they had we'll clean and press any book that you want to get graded. So through a, I guess, a clean and a press on this, this will kick up to a 9.2 at least. But we're going to give it an 8.5. We got our books that we're going to list in this live stream. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 books. So let's do. And usually I don't like putting books on top of each other, right? Like this, because the spine gets stressed out. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do this. This is where the books are going. So we're gonna start off with Rye number 0, and it's 9.6, right? So let me rearrange myself, plug in our phone so we can download the pictures. You're gonna hear a little diddle-diddling, I think, anyway. Okay, now that we don't have to touch comic books, we're gonna have a little drink, and we're gonna turn off this angle here. Let's transfer this. What pictures do we have here right now? I got a bunch of pictures here. Let me sort this out in the folder. Those are those ones. Okay, we can kill these guys. Let me kill these. Okay, let's transfer over the files. There's a whole bunch of picks. How many picks do we got? We have 101 picks. So let's transfer these guys over. Let's move them here. And we're gonna find Rye number 0 is the first one we're gonna miss, right? Now, Rye number 0, we've already sold one. So we're just gonna relist the previous one, because all the parameters will be set properly for it, right? Oh, Rye, where is a Rye? I need to find a Rye that I sold already, so I can just come on. Where are you? There it is. Okay, we're gonna sell similar. That's what eBay has, right? So we're gonna go click sell similar. And it's a 9.6 we gave it. Right? 9.6. Okay. Rye number 0. So I'm just gonna flip it so I know I'm listed that one. 9.6. 9.6, and that's near mint plus. And I sold it for, so 9.4 rye, sold for 26. I listed it at 20, right? Okay, what's going on? If you go to my comic shop, which is, it has stuff listed, you can see CGC graded 9.6 is selling anywhere between 95. Oh, there's a 75. I wonder why it's 75. 9.8 is like for 400. 75 all the way. 9.4 is 100. These are CGC. CGC. So again, I'm just going to list it at, it's a 9.6. Okay, let me load up the pictures. Let me kill these pictures. I'll provide you guys the links as soon as, and eBay just changed their format of loading on pages. Like literally, when I was relisting some stuff yesterday, in the, yesterday I was relisting some stuff, halfway through, all of a sudden the page where they list, where you list comic books, had changed. It's like, damn. Hey Chicho, Zimmy, how are you doing? Intelligent Blueberry, how's life? How's life? Hi everyone, hope you're all doing great. Doing fantastic, crazy bro, Athan. Nice pick, by the way. Pride Wing, Melty Pat. Right, that's cool. Okay, so 9.6, right. I'm gonna transfer over the pictures to the right folder. And all the way here. And I need to transfer it over to the Rise Zero folder. Bring it here. And I guess this is the second set we're selling. Set two. September 2000. I'm trying to stay semi-organized in this, but you know what it is? It is what it is. So let's add the photos. Add photos. We are going to go here, 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 and here, and here, and just load up these books. Okay. While that's loading, let me make sure the description is okay. Display up to 12 supersized images with zoom pictures. Our photo each resolve. Okay. The new options are a little wacko. Valiant 9.6, Bloodshot. Certainly, I don't know what these are. Sorry. What is this stuff? Condition is not applicable to this thing. I've already listed the condition. Near Mint Plus. Let me do this too. We're learning how to navigate the new. What do you call it? The new eBay interface while we're doing this live. So condition. I'm just gonna put down near mint plus 9.6. I'm not gonna mess around with this. And we gotta rotate, and then we gotta, for some reason, come on. This man, their interface rotates. At least this interface is loading up the pictures in the right order that I took them in. The previous interface was not. This one's loading them up all sideways, which is unfortunate. I gotta rotate them all. eBay. Okay. Oh, what's going on? How come it didn't save them in that order? I flipped them, but it didn't save them. It's not even saving them. It's just brightness, snapshot. Oh, come on, eBay. What are you, crazy? No way, man. How do you save it in that drag to erase? gotta save on each one. eBay, you silly little bugger. Sorry if I'm not checking chat, gang. Multicolor, full initiation, kind, caring, mode for a great, wise, open-minded streamer. Thanks, crazy bro. Appreciate the love, man. Appreciate the love. My life is going good. Intelligent blueberry. Well, having a hard time finding a winter jacket. Oh, winter jacket. You need a winter jacket. Well, it depends where you are, actually. Actually, everybody needs a winter jacket. No matter where you are, you need a winter jacket. Oh my god, and eBay has to save them each manually. Apologies about this game. I thought, I didn't realize eBay had done craziness to that. I didn't actually check the picks for the stuff that I relisted. I don't know if they're sideways or not. Weird. I think part of the reason they do this is just because they want you to spend more time on their site, maybe. If you watch some of the other live streams, this process was a lot faster. Come on, save it. Save it. Okay, that's good. That's done. Certification, notify, sign, issue number one. Number one, publication date. Oh, don't you have a publication date? 1992. 1992. Okay, what do we got? What do we got? What do we got? Okay, I gotta grab. There we go. I gotta grab the info from here. From other listings we've done. Because since we sold the last one, I've modified the info, the listing info. Ride number 0, Matthew number 0, 9, near mint plus 9.6. A beautiful book indeed. And let's do this. And let's do this. Let's do this. Let's do first. First. First, full appearance of Bloodshot. Unread. We're going to put in the title. Unread. But never been read. Oops. Never been read in the description. Shipping, grading, over. Okay, 7 day. Anything changed? We're gonna list it at 20. No, we're gonna list it starting at 30. This is a 9.6. The other one was 9.4, so we went with 20. No best offer. Additional trial. I don't know what this is. I don't know what that is. Cannabis. Yes. It's just the same stuff. I don't know if this is gonna allow it. Europe, Asia. The shipping stuff has changed up. Oh my god. Okay, I'm not gonna touch those. I'm not gonna touch those. I'm gonna do a preview. eBay. What a pain. What a pain you are. Oh, issue number 0, not number 1. Issue number 0, where are you? list item. Let's check it out. Let's view the listing. Okay, game. Here you go. Let's make sure this is came out okay. And a lot more first appearances and death. Very important bug. Bloodshot moving these up. Never been red. Never been red. Right, 9.6. Okay, so there's this guy. Let me send it to you. It's normal. They do this like this. They have a kind of monopoly so they can afford to do weird things. Here in Belgium, there was one site who was concurrating them, and they were so badly boycotted by the state that they had to resign. Oh, really? Unfortunate. Yeah, they have a monopoly, basically. Really, it is a monopoly if you want to think about it. Eternal Warrior number 4. Sell similar. Sell similar. Of course, it's gonna go to their new page. Eternal Warrior number 4. What a regret this is. 9.4, 9.6. Okay. Now, the previous one we listed at 9.6, 9.8. And it sold for $53 Canadian, $53.85 Canadian, which was a great deal. I wanna make this 9.4, 9.6. Okay. First appearance of Bloodshot, near mint plus condition. Never, I'm gonna put never been red, and we're gonna change the picks. Oh, I wish I could keep the same picks, seriously. Oops, I'm gonna put the Eternal Warrior, move the picks into Eternal. Eternal Warrior. Bum, bum, bum. Onyx. And we're gonna take it here. Wait a second. What are these guys? Oh yeah, we're gonna go Eternal Warrior here, number 4. This is set number 2. I took 14 picks, so I can't list 14, so I gotta decide which ones I'm gonna list. So none of this does. Let me see if this pick shows it well. So we're gonna do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. I gotta reduce one. Shoot. Okay, I'm not gonna include that one. I'm not gonna include that one. I'm gonna include those two. Okay. So let's load photos. Chicho, how long have you been collecting comic books? For about 30 years, man. Since the late 19. Or my first comic books I have in my collection, which were the Tintin, I had from the 1970s, right? But full on collecting in the mid late 1980s. So 30 years. A good chunk of time. A good chunk of time. These are still loading. Let me do the description for this. Right, let's grab these guys, the grading down. Beautiful book. Near mint plus, near mint plus. 9.4, 9.6. Copy, if not more. Please see books. Rotate these picks. Man, I should have brought myself a snack. Should go get myself a snack. This is like cold tea that I put in the fridge to cool down. It's what is this? This is Tulsi Rose, actually. Can stay the way they are. We'll see how many more books we list after this one. This set. I might just start listing. Maybe take a hiatus for a little while and maybe list some stuff for Christmas time. Okay, that's that. Main character, Bloodshot. Main character, issue number 4, boing. By the way, for you comic book collectors, have you noticed how many comic book runs, series have an important, one of the most important issue in the series is issue number 4, where they introduce new characters or there's a major shift happening in the story and everything like that, right? Okay, this should work. List it. We'll check it. Like, there's so many comic book runs where number 4 is so important. I should be checking the pics to make sure they're all oriented okay. That's good. Nice.
So that's another one down.
Let's do Infinity Gauntlet number one. Infinity Gauntlet number one. Snack time. Do you know the comic book Storm? Storm from X-Men? It's made with airbrush. It's the same design as Tigress. No, Tigress? I don't know what that is. That a character or a comic book? So Eternal War, sorry, Infinity Gauntlet number one, graded 9.4. Wait, let me check. Okay. Infinity Gauntlet number layers one. Let's list this. Cell similar. So this one I sold was 9.4 as well, so we can keep that. We can go near mint 9.4. Never been red. I wish I could keep the same pictures, but we can't. We gotta load on the new pictures. Infinity Gauntlets. This is gonna be the fourth Infinity Gauntlet number one we're selling or listing. Number four. September 2019. So we gotta copy the pics there. Infinity Gauntlets. That's 12 pics. Let's upload these pictures. Four is 12 picks. We can load 12 picks. Well, those guys are loading. Let's set these guys up. And copy these guys over. Maybe they improved their editor. Around with the editor, eBay's editors was horrendous or is horrendous. Starting price 20. Starting price 20. Let's check it out. Oh, yeah, what did we list Eternal Warrior for? Oh, we started at 20. We can't start Eternal Warrior number 4 at 20. That's crazy talk. We gotta start this one higher. Let me change this one. Sorry, gang. I forgot about that. I was willing to let go of the first one or list it at 20. This one, not so much. This one, we're gonna go 40. Update listing. Designed the comics of the Trigon Empire. No, I don't know it. I don't think so. Here's Eternal Warrior number 4. I kicked it out to a 40 because it's just not willing to let it go for less than that. It's a really important book. Let's check out the Infinity Gauntlet. Let's make sure it's all good. Oh, it's not rotated. Oh, yeah, we didn't rotate the pictures. We gotta rotate the pictures. We have to rotate the pictures. And this Infinity Gauntlets, all the other ones I started at 20. This is the fourth one. This we're gonna start at 30. Now's the rotation time. Truth, I'm not sure if we're gonna list use up all the 50 comics for September. We'll see. So again, if I promise that I'm gonna list something, please remind me before we start crunching the numbers, because I'm pretty sure once I get into crunching the numbers, I'm not gonna be listing too much more stuff. The mermaid stuff I'll take pics off on the list later. The eye for an eye things. Oops. That one's okay. That one's okay. Rotate this one. This should be it. So let's list it and see what happens. Let's take a look at it. Cool, so that's Infinity Gauntlet number one. What else we got? Amazing Spider-Man 346. And we graded this a 9.2, 9.4. And we mentioned there's a minor crease on the cover C-pick, right? So, and we sold one of these already. So we're gonna scroll all the way up because we sold it recently. And da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da, where are you? Where are you? There you are. There you are. 346. Sounds similar. Let's do the grading. Oops. Change the text on it. So this was the one we sold. We graded it near mint minus 9.2, went for 36. Okay. And there's one person that was grabbing all these. They wanted them. And we graded this at 9.2, 9.4. So 9.2. Near mints, 9.2 and 9.4. Oops. 9.4. Okay. Let's change the text part of it. Copy it. Yeah. Now I'm gonna do this. Paste. Near mints. Near mint, 9.2. But one minor crease, one very minor crease on spine. One very minor crease. To see grade for yourself. Never been read. Okay. Okay. that's that. Where are we? Okay, so I gotta change those. eBay, you suck. 9.2, 9.4. Okay, copy. Pictures? How do we load up the pictures? No, we didn't load up the pictures. We gotta load the pictures. Two, three, four, five, six, seven. This one or no? No, that one's blurry. Okay, so we're gonna kill this guy. So what do we got? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Those are the pics we're gonna grab. Add photos. Spider-Man. And we're gonna grab all these guys. That should be 12 pics. Have to load. I'm just gonna check the chat. Mask of Raven, how are you doing? How is life? Nicholas. Oh, there's such a slow load as well. Crazy. So slow. I mean, it does load them all in the right order. It's just rotated. Unfortunately. Next, rotate. Every single one's gotta be rotated. Next. Hey, what's going on? Next. Next. Rotate. Dunk. Next. Rotate. Dunk. This is the first appearance, I think, of Venom's green gook in his mouth. And what is supposed to represent that? What's his name? Aaron. The person who's writing Venom right now, Donnie Gates, has stipulated in the books. So slow, this thing. Is that it's his digestive stuff when he's eating people. Right. Gook. Venom gook. Hey, what's going on? Stay where I know what I'm doing. X, how are you doing? How is life? Good. Been studying for math. Math for 10 hours now. Mask of Raven. Oh my god. I remember those days. I do other things for 10 hours now. Making crab apple butter right there for 10 hours now. Starting at a 10, what's it going for, man? These are good last books. The Amazing Spider-Man 346. I kicked them off at a fairly low start. I mean, this thing's being listed at 45 and stuff, so Infinity Gauntlet we said 30. We're kicking up this last lot game. Just because this might be the last little bunch we put in there, and they are sought after bucks. We're gonna start at 20. We're doubling the starting bid on it. Okay. It went for 36, I believe, anyway. A lower grade than this. So. And this would be graded 9.4, but we'll put the 9.2 in there too. Here is Spider-Man 346. Okay, next we want Amazing Spider-Man 360. And this one, we sold one that was graded at 9.6 for 34. And this one graded at 9.6, 9.8. Okay. It's a beautiful book. This is a 9.8. It's not just a 9.6, it's a 9.8. But we put 9.6 in there. 9.6 sells similar. First appearance, Carnage cameo reveal. Cameo. Okay, we're gonna make enough room so we can do this. I'm gonna go near mint. Mint 9.6, 9.8, and of course never been read. Condition. Never been read. Gotta load up the pictures, right? So we're gonna load up from here to here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Yeah, the jack. The 12 picks. So add photos. You want 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Okay. 9 point grade. 9.8. Near mint. Still loading the picks, so let's do the copying, the grading things more consistent with the description. Paste. Now we're gonna flip the pictures. Okay, let's flip them and save them. Save. 12 picks. Might as well be consistent. Who was the genius at eBay that thought that this was a good idea? Guaranteed this is going to reduce the number of listings people do because it's going to take more time. I would fire them. You're out of there. They must have a time factor involved in this. At least bring the pictures up in the right way. Oops. Next. Oh yeah, there it is. Oh yeah, this one. Gotta say, that's what I gotta say. Let me do this. I'm gonna put, what am I gonna put? I'm gonna put minor string. No. No, that's not it. See if this one has it. No. This one has it. Say, hopefully this isn't gonna mess up. So we said, what grade did we say? 9.6, 9.8. And up. Oh yeah, this one has it already. Nice. That's good. 9.6, 9.8. Near mint. Near mint. Oops, did I put near mint up there? Yep, okay. Near mint up there. Near mint. 9.8. A beautiful book. Beautiful book. One. Beautiful. Okay, those are good, 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 those are good. We started this at 30. And it sold for 34. We're gonna start it at 30 again. It's an important book. First cameo appearance, really, of Carnage. Is the first cameo the one previous? You see the Carnage gook, or the Carnage red symbiote, right? Oh, I didn't take any pictures of Hathor's face anyway. That's okay. I don't put the gun on the bottom of the back covers. It would never been red. Okay, and that's that one. Amazing Spider-Man 362, right? And we graded this as 9.6. Let's put it down here. 362. Sounds similar. I'm gonna grab these, the grading stuff. And we're gonna go here. It's near mid plus. Plus second full appearance of Carnage. Let's see if Venom is in there too. Boom. Yep, that fits in there too. Near mint plus 9.6. these pics and load them on and adjust the description accordingly. There we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Grab them. 9.6. Yeah, 9.6. This one sold for 36. Oh yeah, let me grab this grading stuff, copy and paste the description here on the bottom part. So all I've done is, other than the mermaid comics, the description of everything is the same below the grade, right? So I got description of book and then grade. And then everything else below in the description of the listings is the same thing, right? So all I've done is just cut and pasting that on because I modified it a little bit to this point, right? The mermaid stuff, for the books, I've also included the synopsis of the books. What the books are about, because I published them. I know them. I have them handy. They're the same ones. Come on. It'd be funny too. Take a look at the previous listings that we did and how long it took to arrange the pictures, and we'll get a time comparison of how much longer it's taking to do this. And more clicks. Annoying. Have I complained about this enough? After this, I think we've got two more books to list. Right? One of them we have to find through eBay search. Oh, that was an experience and a half. I started the last one of this at 25. I started at 25. So, and it was a 9.4, 9.6. This one we're giving a 9 straight, 9.6. Oh no, what are we giving this one? 9.6. Oh, I forgot to change the description here. Near mint. Plus 9.6. So we should just start this one at 30. Let's check this out. Yeah, we should just start this one at 30. Okay, 30 it is. 30 it is. When we get lower and the number of books we have, the price goes up, it's costing more, or there's less of them we have. Let's check it out, make sure it's listed okay. Take a look. Second full appearance of Carnage, more and more comics like this. Oh, I didn't, never. Oh, I forgot to include Nerven, right? I did, I swear I did. This one, did I guess send you guys the link of this one? I don't know if I did or not, but let's just change this one. Never, then, So here's the 362. Okay. Then what do we got? What do we got? What do we got? What do we got? We got Archer and Armstrong number 0 and Lobo Omega Man number 3 we're gonna list, right? So let's do Omega Man number 3 first. Cause and we graded this at 8.5. Omega Man number 3. We sold one already which was in good condition, I guess. It was reader's copy. There was nothing missing, nothing torn or anything, it's just crunched up. Sold it for $21.50, right? Sells similar. This one is gonna be great. 8.5, very fine plus. Right. First appearance of Lobo DC Comics. DC Comics. Very fine plus 8.5. And it's never been red. Unread. Unread. Never been red. Let's kill these pictures. And let's find the pics we have. This we have an Omega Man folder. Lobo. No, okay, so we got Lobo. Let's just make this September 2019. And we're gonna go. Where are we? Lobo, boink. All the way to boink. Lobo. Let's put it here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Okay, so we're not going to include the full back cover one. Right. So let's do that. Let's go eBay. Lobo. Set number 3. We're going to move this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So we're not going to include the full back cover one. Okay, well, that's sorting itself out. Let's do the cut and paste. And do the description because we're gonna have to write something about that. Not 100% sure what we're gonna write about it. We just have to say it got scrunched. Very fine plus, 8.5. Let's change this to boink. Verify plus 8. Oh yeah, I'm gonna arrange the pics. Let's rotate the pics before we get into the description. Oops. Save. Feeling other than the mermaid comics, this is the last set of books we're gonna list unless I get some requests. Okay, so if you're watching this on another platform, eBay, YouTube, BitChute, or if you're watching this live, if you know the comic book video we had where I showed you 4 small boxes. We sold about 1 small box. We sold about a quarter of those bucks, right? please remind me, or just say, Chicho, you promised to list this book, can you please list this book? The New Mutants 98, the odds are I'm gonna send it in to be graded. Okay, our first book to be sent in. We might do a video of might do a video of grading it just to see what we think the grade is, and then send it in. I want to send it in with Go-Go Boy Comics. Oh, one image didn't make it. Why not? Image error. Ah, you eBay, you suck. Let's add. Which one is that? That's this one. Which one is it? Oh god, I gotta remember which one it is. So we got this. Which one is this one? We got the bottom. We got that one. We got this one. Stream tonight, Chicho, huh? Enjoying it all the same though. Yeah, very quiet. I think it's also fall. I'm not sure how many people are here. We've got around 10, 11 people here, which is cool, which is awesome. Nice and chill. I like it. Okay, we got this. We got this. What we're gonna write here, this is a beautiful book. This is a beautiful book. And would have graded 9.4 if it wasn't for the top left. Left corner of the front cover being the little squished. And I'm pretty sure squished is not the official term that people use. Squished. Creating some folds and creases. Pretty sure a press will fix most of that. Please see pics to decide grade for yourself. And never been read. Have you guys kicked into fall mode, Nicholas? Is it raining there? Anvil Eyes. I am pretty much an exclusive lurker who has Chicho on the background often. Awesome. Thanks for lurking, Anvil. I lurk a lot on a lot of different things as well. Oh my, gotta kill that one. First appearance of Lobo. First full appearance of Lobo. Full appearance of Lobo. Verified. This is a beautiful book and would have graded 9.4. Should we get a text-to-speech reader or a thing? No, I'll be too loud. Oh no, because you'll hear it. I won't hear it. This is a beautiful book and would have graded 9.4 if it wasn't for the top left corner of the front cover being a little squished. Creating some folds and creases. Pretty sure a press will fix most of that. Grading, got those. So, What is Omega Man number? Omega Man number 3 going for in very fine plus condition. Let's check it out. Let's check it out. Let's check it out. Wow, very fine is being listed at 112. There's a near mint that's 80. Near mint minus is 80. So it's being listed for 100. Let's check out here. I'm gonna check out eBay's what do you call it? Advanced search where completed listings. Omega Man number 3. Sold listings. Let's see what it's going for on eBay. It's probably going for less on eBay. Yeah, it's going for less on eBay. A graded 9.6 sold for 91 Canadian. That's a great price. Who bought that? That's got to be a reseller. I hope it's a collector. Low rating. Come on, come on, come on. Yes, good. A reseller wanted to get their hands on it. Nice. Okay, so. Okay, let's do the starting price on this at. We're gonna do a starting price on this at 30. That's cheap. Oh my. Lobo, he's all getting his own TV series. Let's go 40. Are we willing to let it go for cheaper? TV show in the works. I'm gonna put this in here too. TV show in the works. 40? No, let's do it 30. I'll list it at 30. Where is it? Where is the pricing thing? Oh, there it is. Let's say we do 30. Okay. It's gonna sell for more. DC TV show. Can we do DC Comics? Oh, it fits. Nice. Never been rat. Okay, let's do a preview. First full appearance of Lobo. First appearance of Lobo is one of the visual on red. Yeah, that looks good. Oh no, I gotta change that. I gotta go through and fix up some of these things because in the cell, I did change it. Okay, let's see if it's gonna fix it. eBay's preview even sucks. I fire a lot of people at eBay personally, starting with the CEOs. Did it fix it? Yes, it did. Okay, good. Because the preview doesn't even show up correctly when you're doing it. Fun. Okay, that's done. That's done. Now what do we want? Now we're going to list something new that we haven't listed before, right? We are going to list Archer Armstrong number 0. Let's find it and list it. Where are we? There we go. Okay, we don't need this guy. And we don't need this guy. Okay. Archer. And Armstrong. And Armstrong number 0. Valiant. Archer Armstrong number 0. When did it come out? I think it was 2001, wasn't it? Archer Armstrong number 0. Boom. Barry Windsor Smith. 2000. That's 2001. 1992. Superheroes. What are my choices? Independent small press, superhero. This one. Let's see if we can find the right one. Oh, what? It didn't even. Did it fill anything? Oh, I didn't even choose anything. Oh, I didn't even look for similar. Yeah, that's what it is. Archer Armstrong, number 0, 1992. First appearance. Let's do this. Let's grab it from here. Barry Windsor Smith. Okay, we do it this way. First appearance of Archer and Armstrong. Let me bring it here. First appearance of Archer and Armstrong. Okay, Valiant. First appearance, let's see if this is going to be this. First appearance with Archer and Armstrong. Valiant. And what did we grade this as? 9.4, 9.6. So near mint. Near mint. Oh, no room, no room. How do we make more room here? First appearance, Archer and Armstrong. We take out the of. We take out the comma. Near mint plus 9.4, and it doesn't fit. We take out Valiant. We do want Valiant in there. I'm just gonna go near mint plus 9.4. Come on, give me enough room. Oh, not there. That only saves two spaces, maybe. Let's do first appearance Archer. First appearance Archer Armstrong. 9 point. Oh, I need two more spaces. Okay, we're gonna change this up. We do want Valiant in there. So I'm gonna change this up. I'm just gonna go first appearance. And I'm gonna take out Archer and Armstrong because Archer and Armstrong is in the title. So first. First appearance. Let's make sure we spelt it correctly. And then Valiant, 9.6, unread, nice, unread works, so I'm going to kill this, Valiant, unread, let's put a little, that's good enough, okay, near mint plus 9.4, 9.6. Never been read. We gotta load up the picks. Let's put the picks in the right folder. Do we have a Valiant folder? No, we don't. We're gonna create an ANA folder. Strong picks. And we're gonna put them here. And we're gonna move them here. Quick. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Let's load up the picks. A and A. Let's load these up and then we deal with the description. Publisher, Valiant. 4, 9.6. Near mint plus 9.4.6. Year 1992. Main character. Archer and Armstrong. Series Archer. And Armstrong, issue number 0, publication date 1992. What's the issue? 1992. Okay, we gotta copy all this. First full appearance of Archer and Armstrong. Archer and Armstrong. Wow, there is no TV show in the works for this, not as far as we know. Oops, there should be. Let's see if we're still. Oh, wow, nice lighting here, eh? Let's just look at the video. That was the text. Sorry, did you ask me? No, Chicho, no, Nicholas, it's all good. I was just asking you how fall is faring. It's not fall yet, it's end of summer. Lions, hey Chicho, how's it going? Going good, brother. Just about to finish all this. Let's do this. This is a beautiful book. It is a beautiful book. Secrets never been read. First full appearance of Archer and Armstrong. 1992. I'm going to put those in there. 1992. Valiant Comics. Oh, yeah. We better rotate all this. Mr. Hizakai, how are you doing? Welcome back to another live stream. A comic book live stream where we're listing 9 comic books so far. Well, this is the last one I'm going to list today for this live stream. I made some promises to people to list some comic books, so I'm putting them up. There might be more coming, just because there's a few other books that I promised people that I would list. And this is Barry Windsor Smith art, by the way, which is quite, quite beautiful. So when this is said and done, we've probably sold about a quarter of the books. That, not even, about a maybe 1/5 of the books that we went through. Winter is definitely approaching in Northern Ireland. It's cold, wet night tonight. It's 12 midnight, 12:17 a.m. I'm in India right now. Wow, nice. India's going through a little bit of crazy time with Kashmir stuff, but we leave politics for politics streams, right? Lots of stuff going on. Oh, we do save here. Absolutely freezing here in public as well, like us. 9 degrees. Ooh, 9 degrees. 9 degrees is not freezing. 9 degrees is about to get into freezing. It's getting cold here too. It's getting cold here as well in Vancouver. Let's check this stuff out. Okay, let's see what we got. Archer Armstrong number 0. 1992, first appearance, Valiant, unread, near mint, plus 9.4, 9.6, because we can't put the near mint in there. Oh, can we? Oh, yes, we can. Nice, nice. Let's do, can we put that in there? Yes, we can. That is sweet. Can we put that in there? Yes, we can. What's going on? Nice. Description. Nice. That's good. That's good. That's good. This is a beautiful book. See, Grace with Zeller, John Valiant Comics, first appearance of Archer Armstrong. Let's put 1992. What's in there? I should put Barry Windsor Smith in there. I wonder if this is going to muck it up if I cut and paste. Please don't muck it up. Please don't muck it up. I'm just going to write it. I'm scared it's going to muck it up. I don't trust eBay's editor. Barry Windsor Smith art. Jim Shooter's script, I believe. Should be Bob Layton. Bob Layton and Jim Shooter. Jim Shooter and Bob Layton story. Jim Shooter and Bob Layton story. I'll make sure I spelled Layton correctly. People have weird names. So says Gicho. Layton. Everybody should have a weird name. Okay, is my shipping okay? Yeah. Okay, let's do a preview. Let's see how it looks. Beautiful book. Okay, that looks good. Let's list it. It looks like there's a problem with this listing. Oh, I gotta give a starting price. Where is the starting price? What did we decide the starting price was going to be? Where is the starting price part? Man, I can't find it. There it is. Nice. What are we gonna start the price? Bidding. I don't know what this is going for. $15. We're not willing to take less than 15 for it. It might not even go for 15, I guess. It might be cheaper. Let's check it out. Let's see how much it's going for on eBay sold. Because this is a cheap book, which should be. Archer and Armstrong number 0. Let's see how much it's sold for. Oh, there you go. Oh, that's the gold. Oh my God, someone bought it. Near mint. The $1, that's crazy talk. $2, wow, wow, wow. $22, $10. Someone got an amazing deal. Oh, look at the price, $13. I guess this is going for so cheap. Yeah, 15 is minimum I'm gonna list it for this. Definitely, incredible. It's weird, the comic book industry is weird. Such an important book. Let's see. Preview. Let's see how it looks. $15. Yeah. Let's kill that. Let's list it. Let's see what it looks like. And then I gotta go back and check all these listings, make sure they're all listed legit. Hopefully. Here's the listing for Archer Armstrong number 0. Boing. Politics, Nicholas, thank you for that. It's really pretty and really depressing. India, yeah. The poverty and pollution are out of control, yeah. I know a few people that that live have lived in India, live in India, go back and forward between here and India. Yeah, a lot of people have said many things about it, but they still love it. They keep on going back. Good to see you, bro. Yeah, definitely getting chilly. Keep the politics and other heavy subjects to their respective streams.
Yes, yes, yes.
The politics, what do you call it? Bot Nicholas brought about, I think it's that cold wind of Brexit City. But let's check it out. Let's see what we got. See other listings. So right now we have we have how many listings? We got 22 listings up. Okay. And we have how many more we can do? We can do another 20. No, another 30. Okay. I can do another 30 listings. Not sure if I'm gonna get to them. Okay. We'll see what happens. Fun. And how long have we been up at this? Up to 2 hours and 40 minutes. Okay. I think we'll call it there. I had planned on listing more today, but that's not bad. We got 22 up. So if anybody wants to combine shipping, there's enough comic books, some key ones that they can get their hands on if they want to. Okay. And right now we have the following books up. I'm gonna have the Eye for an Eye and Lander up too. I will now list those, try to list those this week. We got Gogo Boy Ashcan, Gogo Boy number 2, Gogo Boy number 1, Gogo Boy number 3, Shadow Man number 7 and 8, which is the first appearance of Master Dark Valiant Comics, Starry Night number 1, Starry Night number 2, Starry Night number 3. Those are my books as well as the Gogo Boy, the Mermaid Publications. We got Silver Surfer number 50, which is the origin of the Silver Surfer and prequel to Infinity Gauntlet. We got Sandman number 8, which is the first appearance of Death by Neil Gaiman. We got Incredible Hulk 377, which is a first print, which is the first appearance of Professor Hulk. We got Superman number 50 in a newsstand edition. We got Eternal Warrior number 5, which is the second full appearance of Bloodshot. We got September Morning number 1, which is sort of a comic book that came out for September Morning, Mark Silvestri and Emily Lazar. Okay, we got Rye number 0, which is the first full appearance of Bloodshot. Okay, we got Eternal Warrior number 4, which is the first appearance of Bloodshot. We got Infinity Gauntlet number 1, which is Infinity Gauntlet number 1, first print. We got Amazing Spider-Man 346, okay, Eric Larson. We got Amazing Spider-Man 360, first appearance of Carnage cameo. We got Amazing Spider-Man 362, second full appearance of Carnage. We got Omega Man number 3, first appearance of Lobo. Okay. And we got Archer and Armstrong number 0, which is the first appearance of Archer and Armstrong. Okay. Some keys in there. Some good books in there. Some very high grade books in there as well. I hope you guys enjoyed, man. I hope you enjoyed this nice little chill session. You saw, no, at the last second, I get a little dude coming in. 7K lifer. No, brother. You gotta come to Canada. Canada, it's legal cannabis. So go crazy if you're of legal age. Thanks for the stream, Chicho. My pleasure, Nicholas. Thanks for sticking around. Brilliant. Roll on payday. Nice. Lions. Crazy old gamer. You're so hard to hear. It's like chi ASMR. Crazy old gamer. Just like ASMR. And we're getting the sunset as well. Fantastic. Thanks for being here, gang. I hope you guys have a fantastic week. Today is Monday. And I'll try to pop in at some point. Oh, I'm gonna ban somebody just before we go. Oh, I'm gonna ban. Nice. I haven't banned anybody for a while. Texas. Fix. Did it work? Did it work? I don't know if it. Yes, it did. Nice, nice. A nice ASMR chill way to end the stream. Bye, everyone. Hope you have a fantastic week.